So after this seven seas and 13 rivers and desert of the panther, we come to the theme of the poem. What is the theme of the poem? What is the inner meaning of the poem? The poet expresses the imaginative wandering of a young child who sees a boat at the wharf and thinks that it is such a waste to let the boat stand there for days. And this is the reason he mentions in the poem, uselessly laden with jute. Why? Because he feels that the boat is actually, it's not working. And it can be used to go to the fairyland, but it is uselessly laden with jute and it is kept idle there. Nobody is using it for so many days. That is why he uses the term uselessly laden with jute and idle over there. So here he says that it is such a waste to let the boat stand there for days when it can be used for such a beautiful purpose. He imagines where he would go and what he would do if once he is permitted to take the boat and sail. Then he starts his imagination of going to different far-off places, and what he will do, he will be the prince of his story. He will take his friend along with him, and he will reach the land of the strange king, crossing the ford of Tirupurni and the desert of the panther. So these are all his imagination. Now we come to the figure of speech of the poem. What do we mean by this term, children? Figure of speech. Like, for example, I'll give you a very simple example. Suppose you go to a party. Whenever you go to a party, you dress up beautifully. Do you wear the same dress that you wear regularly? No. You take a special dress out from your cupboard. Then you wear matching shoes, matching specs or goggles along with it, isn't it? So you dress up specially for that particular occasion so that you look beautiful, you look smart in that occasion. Figure of speech is also the same thing. In simple words, figure of speech means giving a special ornament to the poem so that when you read the poem, you feel interesting to read it. A figure of speech is a phrase or word having different meaning than its literal meaning. It can be written in a very simple word, but will it that be that interesting? No. So if I give it a special touch, you know, a party wear, that type of touch to the poem also, then it gives a beautiful meaning to the poem. So that is what is called a figure of speech. It conveys meaning by identifying or comparing one thing to the another. So it can be either an identification of any particular thing or comparing two things. Okay? In this poem, we have used the figure of speech of called simile. Simile. What is that? What is a simile? Simile is a figure of speech that makes a comparison between two completely different things using words like as or like. So if I say as brave as a lion, so what does it mean? Does it mean that the boy or the girl whom I'm telling as brave as a lion is a lion? No. But I'm comparing his bravery with that of the more brave animal, right? Of a lion. Clear? So we are comparing the two different things using words like as or like.
See here. Simile means a comparison between two things using as or like. Here are two things that can be compared. For example, a girl, she has blue eyes. See, blue eyes, blonde hair, and bright smile. And we are comparing with the sun. The sun is round, yellow, and bright. So how can we say? Her smile is as bright as the sun. Right? Her smile is bright like the sun. So here, either we are using the word as or we are using the word like. Is it clear? Now children, here I want to mention that there is another figure of speech which is called a metaphor. A metaphor also means the same. That is, a metaphor is also a comparison between two things. But in a metaphor, we do not use words as or like. Her hair is silk. This is a metaphor. Her hair is silk. Her hair is as soft as silk. This is simile. So you can understand the difference between the two. A metaphor does not use words like as or like, and a simile uses words like as or like. Clear, children? In this poem, where can we find simile? In this poem, the line, "I am not going into the forest like Ramchandra," represents a simile. Okay? Why over here simile? Because here I is referring to the little boy who is a human being. And Ramchandra, we generally refer to Lord Ram. So he is a god for us. So here we are comparing a human with God, Ramchandra. So that is why it is a simile. By using the word like. So it is a simile. Is it clear, children? Now we come to the last part of this poem. That is the word meanings. Here are the few words which are given and their meanings along with it. Idle means lazy or not working. Oars, a long pole with flat blade used to row a boat through water. Hoist sails, to raise a flag or sail to its highest position. Steer, guide the movement of a vehicle. Weep, cry, merrily, happily, strange, unknown. Okay, so these are the meanings from the poem. Now children, what is your homework? Your homework is to understand what is a simile, or first, what is a figure of speech, and then what do you mean by simile and metaphor also. You will first listen to my video and understand the meaning between simile and metaphor. Okay, then what you will do is, you will write at least 3 examples of simile and 3 examples of metaphor in your practice notebook. I repeat, write 3 examples of simile and 3 examples of metaphor in your practice notebook. And then you can send me a pic of the picture of the work you have done, so that I can say whether it's right or you need to change it. Is it clear? So please, children, do not do it in a fair notebook. Write down the examples of simile and metaphor in your practice notebook. Then you can click pictures and send it to me so that I can revert back to you. Okay? Thank you, children. Have a nice day and be safe and healthy.